Hello everyone, I'm Shannon Slatton in downtown Osseo. Every day our news team is out in the northwest suburbs bringing you stories and information from your community. Here's a look at a few of those stories. And remember, you can always find more on our website, ccxmedia.org.
An Osseo School District staff member who recovered from COVID-19 is sharing her story. She aims to bring hope for those going through the same experience.
I had a 5-day migraine, severe lower back pain into the legs, which I was told was another symptom, and just super exhausted.
It wasn't long until Katie Dennison and her family noticed COVID-19 symptoms after a trip to Wisconsin Dells in March.
My whole family had it. My husband came down with it first, not knowing. He thought it was just a cold.
Dennison, who works at Fair Oaks Elementary, says when she and her husband felt pressure in their chests, it was time to call the doctors.
Frustrating.
But they couldn't get tested, despite Dennison having an autoimmune disorder.
We were told at that point they were not testing. Because this was back in March, they were only testing essential workers.
The family quarantined for about a month. Doctors recommended taking zinc and vitamin D.
Our oldest, who's 14, had it for about 24 hours with a fever and the body aches. And then our youngest, who's 11, had for about 48 hours.
2 months later, the family tested positive for antibodies, indicating exposure to the virus that causes COVID-19.
We have done some research. My husband's looked at donating plasma. So to me, if they want plasma with antibodies in it, I feel like that's something that will help people.
While the aches and exhaustion were tough to handle, Dennison wants others to know there's hope.
Encouraging people who might be living in fear that, you know, good health and taking care of yourself, it is possible, even with an autoimmune illness, to beat the virus.
In Brooklyn Park, Pafua Yang, CCX News.
It's happening all over the country.
Contraband Chinese seeds have been hitting people's mailboxes.
There are basically two scenarios. Some people have not placed an order for seed and they're getting this package unsolicited. And the outside of the package says earrings or jewelry or something like that, and then they open it up and there are seeds inside.
By labeling the packages as jewelry, they never go through agricultural customs.
Another scenario is that they've ordered something, seeds online, the order was never fulfilled, and then weeks to months later, they got this shipment of seeds, but the packages are marked the same way. They're marked with something other than seeds on the outside, and then inside they open it up and find seeds.
The mystery seeds have become the subject of a federal investigation by the U.S. Department of Agriculture.
And the seeds themselves have no labeling at all. They're just in these plastic sealed containers. It's a small package. And we're seeing lots of different types of seed being shipped in.
There are numerous potential problems with unknown seeds entering the country from places like China.
The risk is, because it's seed and we don't know what it is, it could be something that could be invasive, or it could have a seed-borne disease that we don't have here yet in the U.S. And so we could introduce, you know, some pathogen that we don't have yet. And any of that really is a threat to agriculture and to our food supply.
Okay, so you've received this unsolicited package in the mail. You open it up, it's got a China Post on it, and inside it's got this weird package of unmarked seeds in it. So now what?
We have an Arrest the Pest hotline. There's a phone number and an email. I recommend the email option because you're going to get better information more quickly if you use email.
Definitely don't plant the seeds and don't just throw them in the trash. We'll have links to the Minnesota Department of Agriculture with information on what to do if you've received some of the Chinese mystery seeds. In Brooklyn Park, Neil Pursley, CCX News.
Harmony Bridge is a nationwide program that started like 10 years ago, long before the COVID-19 hit us. And the whole concept of Harmony Bridge is for school band kids of all ages, from elementary through high school, to prepare small group songs to go out and play for senior residents all over the country. So it's not about just about the music, but it's about the connection of generations, hence the name Harmony Bridge. So now with COVID-19, it's taken on a little bit different twist. And I think the need is even greater than it ever was before, obviously, because people are so isolated and shut off. And so we can't go inside and visit, but we can play outside as long as the weather's good. This is something really special, not only for the residents, but also for the kids, because they start to see the power of music. They're not just learning to play an instrument just for a class, but they're doing something that can really bring joy into people's lives.
Find more local news stories at ccxmedia.org and follow us on social media.
Looking for local? Even more local? CCX Media gives you the option to connect with your community on multiple levels. CCX Cities focuses directly on what's happening in your city through community corner videos, weekly interviews with local mayors, and features on local businesses and nonprofits. Plus, full coverage of city meetings, community parades, concerts, and much more. Our content can be watched at home or on the go. Connect to what's happening in your community. Visit ccxmedia.org.